everybody. I'm Joe.
And I'm Ab with Alliance RV.
And this is the all-new Avenue 38 DBL. Ab, what are the specs on this thing?
38 DBL is coming in just over 41 feet long and weighing about 12,500 pounds.
Awesome. All right, we're going to take you guys inside and show you what's going on. All right, Ab, right as we take a step inside the entry door here, you walk into a beautiful U-shaped kitchen.
Yeah, this kitchen's jam-packed.
It is. What's going on? Like, what's all the great features that the owner is going to come to find here?
Yep. I'll start with the 16 cube 12 volt Furion refrigerator. So obviously this is a coach that is can accommodate a lot of people on your trip. So that's going to be a huge advantage, having extra space in the refrigerator. Got over 41 inches of space here in this U-shaped kitchen.
Yeah.
So just a lot of room to be able to cook and just navigate around the kitchen.
Yeah.
First thing you'll notice is solid surface countertops throughout, just a really nice residential touch. When it pertains to our cabinets, all hardwood cabinets, they all have a soft close feature, so they're not slamming shut when you're letting go. A big fan of the no reveal. We did a great job. Our engineering team just did a great job of making this extremely residential. You don't see the big 3-inch gaps that you see on a lot of floor plans. So very clean lines, very symmetric. Great size window here that actually opens.
Yeah.
Right? If you're cooking here, you've got a max air fan above you.
Yeah.
This just makes a lot of sense. Just above that, you'll find a 30-inch over-the-range insignia microwave as well. Behind me here, very, very decorative backsplash. This is really cool, Joe, because it's all aluminum.
Oh.
Right? A lot of guys are using plastic or an ABS that, you know, it gets hot, it buckles on you, it comes off.
Yeah.
This is going to hold up for a very long time. This is what you're finding in residential homes. So,
great.
Beautiful feature. Cabinet drawers, just finish off very well here with the new drawer slides, and they're all reinforced for 90 pounds.
So you can support up to 90 pounds in there, and we'll get a closer B-roll shot of these drawers. They're glazed hardwood, so they look very residential.
Yep, you're not, a lot of them will kind of chip off.
Yeah.
Splayers here, so you're gonna be good to go.
Yeah, love that.
Yeah.
And you know, one thing you said is you got that max air fan, fully open window. So I determined that this is a broccoli safe kitchen.
I like it. It is a broccoli safe. Yep.
All right. And then now let's take a step towards the dinette, because you guys did something totally different for your pantry.
Love it.
Let's show them. All right, Ab. So this is one of the first pantries at Alliance that I've seen like this.
Yeah.
And I was super impressed when I pulled this open for the first time.
Very cool, right?
You got beautiful, this large pull-out pantry. Keeps going.
I know. Yeah, this is awesome. We put a lot in this coach. So we had to find a dedicated spot for a pantry that you could put a lot of dry goods in.
Yeah.
I think this is going to certainly serve that purpose. So really excited about this feature.
Yeah, and this wood is really nice, glazed hardwood.
Yep.
You got adjustable shelves here. I don't know if you guys can see that from the camera angle, but you can adjust these shelves. So if you don't want two up here, you put four down here, but one up here, or if you want big boxes up here. Very, very multifunctional.
Absolutely. Just behind me in the dinette, we got very creative here. You've got the two freestanding chairs, a legless dinette table, which I love, Joe, because
you're not going to knock your knee.
We're sitting down here, we're not banging our knee. And where you're sitting, that's a removable ottoman.
Yes.
Right? So that lifts up. There's plenty of storage in there.
Yeah.
An Avenue highlight is always our slide box height. We're 80 inches tall. It's almost a foot taller than a lot of our competitors out there. In this type of floor plan, what I've always found is not a lot of guys give you a direct view of your campsite.
Yeah.
That's where the awning is. That's the picnic table. That's where the kids are going to be running around. It's probably pretty important.
Huge.
Yeah, it is. Big H, and it opens all the way.
Yeah.
But that side and this one as well. So just an ideal location for the window and the dinette. I will note, if a booth dinette is something you wanted to do
instead of a free floating,
it is a no charge option.
Oh, great. Okay. So if you wanted to have a booth dinette instead here, you could put that.
Yep. Some folks might want an additional sleeping area or a way to maximize storage. That's an option.
Great. I love that. All right. And then we're going to take them into the living room, talk about the TV and a very unique feature for a floor plan like this.
My favorite part.
Conversational seating.
Love it.
All right, Ab. So when I walked in this floor plan for the first time, I was highly impressed with this area right here.
Thank you.
Because very rarely do you find this much seating in a coach that has two bedrooms.
You're absolutely right. That's, you know, this is, it's a staple floor plan out there, but what you always find is that, you know, you can sleep 10 and seat 4.
Yeah.
And that's frustrating for a large family. This is a multifunctional coach. It could be for a larger family. It could be, you know, it's very versatile. So there's a lot of different needs it can fulfill.
Yeah.
But I love the cross conversational seating.
Yeah.
We've got a full sleeper sofa here.
Yep.
We've got theater seating with a great view of the TV. And then we've got the dinette that we just spoke about.
Yeah.
So this just works really well. In addition to all that, I'll bring it up again. Got a beautiful view of our campsite.
Yeah.
So this is what we're most excited about on this floor plan. I think we've just taken it up a couple notches.
Yeah. And I know we did display a version of this at the Tampa show, and a lot of people were commenting that this space was very unique.
It went very well. And I'm so glad we brought it there. I mean, as you know, Alliance RV is a company that strives on feedback. It's how we get better. And we got some great ideas to make this floor plan even better. And I think you're going to see that highlighted through this video.
All right. And then the entertainment space, just so you guys know what we're looking at. How big is that TV?
50-inch TV.
So you got a 50-inch TV, Furion soundbar, and beautiful electric fireplace with that aluminum backing back there to match the kitchen.
We use that same composite back there, and that fireplace is kicking off 5,100 BTUs. So, you know, on a chilly night, that could be a real nice feature.
All right. Now, over here is bedroom. I'm going to say number two, technically.
Sure.
Master bedroom is going to be number one.
Yep.
Why don't you take them back there and show everything that's going on back there, and I'll meet you
here.
Let's check it out.
As we work our way to the back of the 38 DBL is a double bedroom loft. You'll notice that you have a 60 by 70 bed back here with a huge atrium window to the right of that. To the left of it, you're going to find a ton of wardrobe space and a great TV location. Just above that bed, you'll find a huge loft. So very versatile offering back in this room with a half bath that leads you to the outside. So it's gonna be very simple to get in and out of that bathroom from the campsite instead of trafficking through the entire camper.
That double bed loft back there was great. That's awesome. You have tons of storage on that bed.
A lot of storage, yep.
So just reiterating back there, you can probably sleep four people back there pretty comfortably, right?
I think pretty comfortably, yes.
Yeah. Full-size adults is what
Full-size adults, yeah. You got a 60 by 70 bed. That loft is even bigger.
Yeah.
And there's great storage above that, as you guys will see. And then even the storage under the bed, right? That's all hinged up. So we maximized storage as much as we could.
Why don't you take them to the front of the trailer and show them the bathroom and the bedroom?
As we work our way to the bathroom, you'll find a ton of features here, starting with the porcelain foot flush toilet. Just above that, you have a great bathroom cubby slash caddy. Great spot to hang those towels, maybe a picture frame, a candle. Just a very versatile offering there. The shower is a very decorative backsplash. That also is the aluminum composite material that we use in our surrounds and our backsplashes. So it's all waterproof and just gonna last much longer. You'll find an illuminated light switch, a very large medicine cabinet, and a ton of storage in the linen closet as well. Now let's check the master bedroom out. Here in the master bedroom, there's a lot of cool features to talk about, starting with this large 72 by 80 king bed. You can option a 60 by 80 in if you wanted a little more room around the beds, but I think you have plenty with the king that we offer. Next to each nightstand, you're gonna have A and C charge ports, 110 outlets on both sides. As we work our way into the closet, lot of space. This is a washer and dryer prep closet as well. Dryer on the left, washer on the right. It's as simple as removing a couple of screws and popping these shelves out. Just to my left, I think we've really done a great job with maximizing storage and converting wasted space into storage. Starting at the top of the dresser here, you've got a flip-up compartment that is just a great spot there. You've also got a bench here with storage below it. Four huge drawers, and then below that, you've got great shoe storage.
All right, Ab. So this coach, the 38 DBL, is just a fantastic family coach. You have so many options and versatility in this floor plan alone. But what are some of the creature comforts you're going to come to find across the board at the Avenue series?
Yeah, absolutely. A handful of those features are going to be carpetless interiors. No in-floor heat ducts, which I love. We don't have those crumb collectors.
Yeah.
All our vents are coming out of our cabinets in different areas. The residential full-flush can lights that are all dimmable just gives you that great residential touch. Shut-off valves at all our major plumbing locations.
Yes.
Just making camping a little easier. On this coach, two standard ACs with an optional third. So yeah, those are just a handful to name.
Love that. All right, so now you guys are ready to see the outside, so we're going to take you there. All right, Ab, now that we're on the exterior, let's talk construction.
Love it.
How is this thing built?
Yep. So one of my favorite things I'll talk about first is the Asdel that we use on the outside of our sidewalls and the inside of our sidewalls. Asdel is a composite material that water doesn't adhere to.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, water intrusion can happen in RVs. So we feel really good knowing that we got you covered there. You're not going to experience any delamination with Asdel. It's also twice as thick when you compare it to Luon, which is going to give us a little more R value, just better insulation overall. We are also using Asdel in our composite floor. So two layers of Asdel on the top and a layer on the bottom.
And then you have two layers on the outside and a layer on the inside.
Correct.
And if I remember right, you got a PVC roof on top. So you're just full 360 covering this thing.
Absolutely. We feel really confident in the construction. That PVC is a wonderful product. It offers you a lifetime warranty. It's 80% more solar reflective. Last thing you want is a lot of heat on that coach.
Yeah.
And it's also very simple to repair if something happened. If a branch hit your roof and you've got a little puncture hole or a snag, per the manufacturer, a piece of PVC, some PVC paste, that's a sufficient fix.
Yes.
So that's really comforting.
Those PVC patch kits could actually be bought at any big box store, the dealerships, really anywhere. They're very commonly available. So not only do you have superior construction with composite materials, but you also beefed up the running gear on what would be considered, it'd be a little beefier than normal.
100%. That's the foundation of this, or of any RV, right? And the glitz, the glam, the features, that's great, but this is where we got to get it right. We did some really cool things. We're using Goodyear Endurance tires. We've also incorporated the Moride CRE 3000 suspension system that has a 3-inch travel slot that is just going to make that ride a lot smoother. Also implemented a 2-inch torsion tube right under our I-beam. It's going to just stiffen that up, strengthen that entire chassis. You'll find that we've welded steel V-brackets in every one of our spring hangers. We're using 1/2-inch shackle kits. In addition to all that, we're using 3,500-pound leaf springs. Wow. So I feel like we've upgraded basically every component in that running gear. I feel we have a best-in-class running gear.
I love that. And that's really important for everyone traveling down the road. You need to have a solid foundation.
100%.
Because these things go through earthquakes.
Safety first.
Yep. All right. Now let's go ahead and talk about storage.
Love it.
All right. So right here is the pass-through storage of the Avenue 38 DBL. And it is big.
It's big.
You got a lot going on here. But the first thing that I noticed were these three little buttons. What are these?
Such a great feature. Three-way switches we've incorporated here. It's just going to make your setup so much easier. So you're able to control all of your slide outs and awnings from the front compartment here, which is a really nice feature, right? We're not hopping in and out of the fifth wheel, a handful of times to ensure we're not hitting a tree or, just again, getting it all done in one shot with a great view of those.
Giving you safety first while you're out here, so exactly you can see those trees or anything. And the slide out that I pressed, you got to hear the click maybe, is if there's a camp table or something just right there, you can see it instead of being on a walkie-talkie or a phone or leaning your head out the door and trying to see.
Makes it so much easier.
So much easier. All right, so what else is going on down here?
Yeah, first thing you'll notice too is we have a 72-inch LED strip light. This is on a motion detector. Just really illuminates this entire pass-through, especially in the evening if you're trying to take something out of here, put something back in when you're leaving. If you're leaving in the evening, it just really does brighten this coach up. You'll also find that we have water shutoff valves. I know I mentioned that earlier, just in the perfect locations. So we've got that for the spray port, the toilet, the sink, your shower. Everything is controlled with a shutoff valve.
Nice.
So,
and then you're also constructed on 101-inch wide body, giving you really more storage overall.
Exactly right, Joe. I mean, that's a huge advantage. 101-inch wide body construction is going to give us a ton of additional storage in the pass-through, but on the inside of the camper, right? We're going to get bigger cabinets. We're going to get more room around the island. It's just going to give you more without adding that length, which is ideal.
I love that. All right, let's go ahead and head to the front of the coach and show them what's going on up there.
Awesome.
All right, now that we're at the front here, let's talk about everything that's going on. It may look like not much, but
there's a lot here. Absolutely. Let's start with the fully automotive painted fiberglass front cap. Yeah. Just a very cool look. I'm excited about this new graphics package. Obviously love the fact that it says Alliance RV on every front cap.
Yep.
So great pop. And it's very monochromatic.
It is.
So it's going to go great with most of your trucks, which are white, gray, black. So it's going to complement that very well.
Yeah.
Just below this front cap, you're going to see we're using a Curt Rotoflex pin box. Nice. Biggest advantage here, Joe, is we have an absorption pad.
Yeah.
Is this going to eliminate the chucking? No, but it is going to significantly dampen it. That stop and go, you're not going to feel it as much when you're making those frequent stops.
Brakes, yeah, okay.
Yep.
And then underneath here, what's going on up in the front storage area?
Yep. So on the Avenue, you're going to get a standard off-the-grid solar package. And what that gives you is a 60-amp charge controller, a 320-watt solar panel. It's prepped for the inverter, and then you've got multiple outlets that are hot and ready to go.
All right, so if you want to add more, you can add more.
Absolutely. We give you a great start, and you can run with that.
All right, sounds good. All right, let's go to the off-camp side. Talk about the features over there.
Awesome.
All right, Ab, now that we're in the off-camp side of this trailer, first thing you notice is this is a little bit of a different door here.
Yeah.
What's going on?
You know, actually, this is some great customer feedback we received. We originally had one large door that would open up on two gas struts. When you think about it, you're always kind of hunched over getting into the pass-through. Yeah. So this really opens it up so that you're not ducking under any baggage compartment doors, and you can get whatever you need much easier with this setup.
Yeah, much easier.
Yeah.
And then you got a lot going on. You got more buttons over here.
More buttons.
More buttons.
We actually had a lot going on this side that I'm excited about. We talked about the three-way switches. Well, obviously, it only makes sense if we bring those slide-out switches on the off-door side.
Yeah, so you can control the two slides that are on this side.
Exactly, making right. that much easier. Another cool thing that we do over here is you'll see that we bungee strap this so that you can access everything behind your Nautilus panel.
Any of the access panels, so winterization or anything that you need to do with your waters right there.
Much easier, right? Yeah. They usually are taking off 10 screws. It's just it's more of a hassle than anything.
Yeah.
Right behind you also point out that I think we've really strategically placed our leveling control system over here. Just gives you a beautiful line of sight of what, and that's what you need to be looking at.
Yeah, I can see the truck perfectly right here.
A lot of guys will put it right here.
Yeah, and you can't see the truck. Wow, yeah,
you're popping in and out.
Yeah,
so.
Very convenient. It seems like a little feature, but that's really important.
I think it is. Yep. Yeah. A couple other cool things that we're doing here. We're using a 60,000 BTU on-demand water heater.
Nice.
A lot of guys are using a 42K. This is going to just ensure that you have hot water at all times.
Yeah, and this is a family coach, so you're going to be able to definitely take those long hot showers.
You're absolutely right. And one last thing I'll show you here as well is just above that, we've got a motion detector light.
Oh, okay.
That can be controlled with the switch, or you can go to the sensor mode. A nice little feature.
Safety feature. If you hear a noise at night, turn that bad boy on and see what's going on in the office.
That's right. Big bear, like
crazy neighbors. Who knows? All right. Love that. Anything else over here? Should we take them to the back of the trailer?
Check out the back of the trailer.
Love it. All right, Ab. So while it may not look like there's much going on back here, there is.
Yep.
Let's talk about
it. Yeah. So first and foremost, very top, you'll see that we're using a universal camera prep. This is just ensuring that the consumer can pick the camera they're choosing. There's a lot of different backup cameras out there.
Yeah.
A lot of manufacturers use a prep that, you know, only allows you to use one type of camera. That camera is probably great, but we just want to give our customer more options, and that's what that does for us.
Love that.
A couple other cool things here. 2-inch receiver. Got the 3-way plug on it. This can handle 300 pounds. You can tow up to 3,000 pounds. So it's just a nice feature. You still have a spot for your sewer hose. We've got a huge sewer hose holder under the coach.
Okay.
So it, you know, because you're losing
that stinky slinky.
It's the stinky slinky.
You put it in there.
Exactly. You also see that we're using a spray port on the back of the camper. I think that this is just a great spot to place it. It's just ensuring that your campsites can always be clean.
Yeah, and one thing I love about this placement is I have two big dogs, and when I take them camping, I actually use the steel ladder.
Oh, that's
tie them up, and then I give them a bath.
That works out.
Can't run away, Fido.
I love it. Speaking of the ladder,
All
steel ladder, 300 pounds is what it's rated for.
Yeah,
it's not the aluminum. It's not the ones that are typically rated for 250 pounds. So this is a great feature, just ensuring that you're getting on top of that roof and down safely.
And I'm a big boy, and I climb these, and I feel safe climbing these.
Yeah, they are very sturdy.
Yeah. All right, and we're not done now, folks. We're going to go ahead and head back to the campsite of this trailer and talk about some features that you're not going to want to miss. All right, now that we're back on the campsite of the trailer, you got this beautiful outdoor kitchen.
Yeah.
Let's talk about what's going on here.
Absolutely. I mean, obviously, this is a necessity, I think. Really cool 3-burner combo griddle/grill here.
Yeah.
Right? So I think this is one of the coolest things out there.
Yes.
You know, you highly grill your burgers, your hot dogs, but you can still do breakfast at the same time, veggies, whatever the case may be. Good size refrigerator as well. I think we checked all the boxes here when it pertains to having a nice
outdoor kitchen.
Correct.
Yeah, I love that. And then it all just locks away under the baggage door.
Yep.
But something else unique is we're giving you two spots for camping on the campsite.
That's right.
Because you got two large awnings.
Two very large awnings. And it's going to virtually cover the entire span of your campsite.
Yes.
So it's just going to be great, especially, you know, if you are cooking and it's not the best weather, a little rainy. We've got you covered.
Got you covered, literally. Love that. All right. Well, let's go ahead and head back to the front of the trailer, and we'll talk about some additional features.
Awesome.
All right, Ab. So while we have talked about this product a lot, we did miss some features.
Yeah, there's a couple things.
Yeah, so let's talk about some of the missed features that we hit, that we didn't hit.
Absolutely. Yeah, a couple features here that I love. Now, this is more about safety for me. So first thing you'll notice is we're using the Moride step above steps. It's a quad step, giving you a really low first step.
Yep.
And it shortens each step.
All the way up.
In addition to that, we're using the Moride safety rail grab handle. I love this feature.
Oh, I love it.
I mean, it goes all the way out to your last step.
Yes.
Again, ensuring that we're getting in and out.
It's sturdier than the other just little grab handles that were very common before this.
Absolutely. And obviously, you know, again, just having that first grab at the last step is very important.
Nice.
Yep.
I love that. And then these step aboves here, they have the little push pin on the button instead of the pins.
That's correct. So there's a trigger on both sides that lets you adjust that leg. Great observation. That makes it so much easier to set up quickly.
Yeah.
We've got a dynamite setup here going in and out of the camper.
Love that. All right. All right, Ab. So this is a 41-foot trailer.
Yeah.
How big are the tanks on this thing?
Yeah, it's a great question. Even on our 34-foot 11 shortest avenue up to our 41-foot 38 DBL, you're going to find every avenue equipped with 106 gallons of gray, 98 gallons of fresh, and a 53-gallon black. Those are industry-leading tank sizes in this segment and something we're really excited about.
I love that. Those are huge, especially when you have families that are camping 100%. In the trailers.
Yep, it's just...
All right. Well, I think that about wraps it up for this floor plan. So join us up front and we'll tell you how to learn more about this floor plan.
All right, folks. That was the all-new Avenue 38 DBL double-bedroom loft. I hope you enjoyed everything we showed you today. Joe, how do our customers find out more about the Avenue 38 DBL?
Absolutely. You guys can go to alliancerv.com, click the Avenue button, and there's tons of information there. Additionally, on any platform that you guys are on social, just search at Alliance RV, and we hope to connect with you. Everybody, thanks for watching.
Safe travels.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
All right, Ab, right as we take a little bit, I can't talk today. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
All right, why don't you go ahead and take them to the front of the trailer and show them the front bathroom and the main bathroom.
Awesome.
Bathroom.
I'm just throwing ideas out there.
Into our time.
Two steps this time.
One hop.
You want some cha-cha now?
I need to hop this direction. He just hears it in his headphones. What are you listening to?
Not us. What do I do with my hands? I'm just sitting over there going like this.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Lift off. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1.
Hi, everyone. I know you've seen me.
Hi, everyone. Thanks, everybody. That was... No, I want you to start.
Okay.
Yeah.
This
okay.
is fun.
Friendship.
Ready? Ready.